Well, welcome back into our Floorball post-game show here from the John Boy Media Warehouse. You guys, we easily just saw the best game of the tournament we've seen throughout this entire tournament. And the championship game, well, it's set. It's going to be Team McFlurry Power taking on We Got Ice, two of the favorites coming into this tournament. This one, though, what we just watched, versus Team Woogas and We Got Ice. Woogas has been an underdog this whole time. They've come in and really with an offensive threat. But it was an overtime period. No shootout. And We Got Ice was able to do it with just seconds into that overtime period. A great matchup. And for the best insight on it, let's get you down to the floor to the guys who called the game. Of course, that's Rosie and Pavel. Guys.
Kelsey, thank you very much. An unbelievable game as We Got Ice takes this one in overtime. DZ with the winner in the first 10 seconds.
It didn't take much time. None of us chose him to score.
Nope.
But he got the only two goals for the team. Let's just hear what he has to say. Look at that hat, like the big head going right to his head here.
Yeah, DZ gets the golden goal. He is the man wearing the black hat. The hero is with Kelsey.
Well, first, did you take any offense to just hearing their comments that nobody picked you to score that goal?
No, not at all, because there's no reason at all anyone should have took me to score. If they saw me during like warm-ups, I was missing the net by like 4 or 5 whatever feet, so I had to keep it in that tight so I'd actually hit the net. So, you know, they just kept pumping belief in me. They kept saying, get in the right positions, and eventually, you know, broken clock. That was the second time it was right today, so.
Yeah, I mean, for you guys to be able to do that less than 10 seconds into the overtime period, was there a strategy discussed, a play that you guys were trying to make?
We were going hard right away because we're like, we don't want that shootout. We have the energy. Let's just keep it going, keep doing what we need to do. And we're just so happy it worked. It was awesome. It was a great team effort.
It was a great moment for you. You got mobbed over there in the corner. This place was going absolutely insane. But another unsung hero.
Yeah. Hero
of this game was your goalie and Jack Doyle. How impressed were you with his performance, only allowing one goal the whole game?
So impressed. Like, I know people were saying we had great defense, but he's been a massive part of that. He gives us so much confidence. It was killer, his save I had. I forget if it was the first or the second, but you know, without that, we may not even get there. So he's a massive unsung hero in this, as you said. And yeah, he deserves all the plaudits here. I'm going to share this hat. There's plenty of hat for him.
You're the man of the hour. Go soak in all your glory. All your fans are waiting.
Game 10 highlights, guys. It's a second semifinal matchup. Floorball tournament. Fan favorite, We Got Ice versus new franchise, Woogas. And this one was intense. We didn't see any scoring till the second period when the one and only DZ put one in the back of the net. But it was a team effort. Every single player on We Got Ice touched that ball before DZ put it right past Lucas DeVersa. And so We Got Ice is up first. The physicality on this team was icy, to say the least. We see Reagan Russ with the defense and the elbows and the pushing, but hey, if the refs don't call it, it doesn't exist, right? But Woogas are not going to give up that early. In the third period, Woogas get on the board with an absolute snipe from Lucas O'Brien, right past the one and only Jack Doyle. Dude didn't stand a chance. He didn't even breathe before it hit the back of the net. So this one goes to sudden sadness. Overtime game, and boy, was it crazy. We see defense, we see hitting, we see slapping, and then we see DZ put it in the back of the net. That's it. We Got Ice is going to the finals. The most improved player, DZ, wins the game for the We Got Ice guys and girls. We love to see the K-Mac dogpile camera. What an absolutely hard-fought game from the Woogas. Absolutely incredible matchup between these two teams. Let's hear from the goalie and Team Woogas on what happened out there.
Well, I didn't want to fuck up come overtime. I mean, the whole game was crazy, and then just like overtime, we haven't seen that in floorball yet, I don't think. So that was nuts energy. You felt it from the stands on the floor, like just didn't want to be the guy to give up a goal, which I was the guy that gave up a goal, so.
I think we moved to the tone of our best player. Reagan's our best player. She's a defense first player, so we got to all adapt and play that way. So we're going to win every game 2-1. That's the new strategy, and don't give up any shots, but fucking DZ, have a game, buddy. Also, Jack, you were nuts. Big saves.
Huge saves.
We needed that.
Needed that.
I think we're the better team, honestly. Our XG, our Corsi through the roof, but just bounces didn't go our way.
Yeah, ran out of gas a little too at the end because we were expecting it to go to a shootout. We were going to a shootout. And we won the shootout yesterday, so we were like, all right, we're going to shootout. And they were like, oh, we got a stopped clock for 2:30 of overtime. And we were like, all right, so that's going to be like 5 minutes of overtime. And Yeah.
Can I just say he's the most coachable person ever? The two goals that he got today, we were working on right before the game, and he just nailed them in. And I was like, if you hit into the goalie, just get the rebound. Just keep going. He's fucking killing it.
As Reagan just said, and honestly, all you guys, they've just been such good coaches where I'm like, I just got to get the energy. I knew I had that from the first game, and they gave me such great advice, but they create such space out there, and I just had to bury, and it happened twice, and all kudos to them, though. So you guys have given me the courage to kind of do that.
Team vibes are high.
This was awesome. Like, I had so much fun. I really want to keep playing.
Yeah.
Sucks.
Monster Wooga, Wooga for life. We were the first four Woogas ever, and I think I'm going to remember that for the rest of my life.
OG Woogas.
I think in our first game against McFlurry, all their goals were like breakaways, and I don't think we've given up a breakaway since.
Jack yelled at us, so we all learned.
And then,
he was like, guys, no more.
And now we play them again, so I think they're going to have a very different look.
Yeah, I think we have the best cardio of any team in the tournament, so we can just run. Like, I can go again right now. So we can stay with them all day, and I think last time we played McFlurry, they scored two goals in the first, and then we locked them up. So I think we got this.
So it seems like spirits are still really high for Team Woogas. We do expect them to be back next year. That's a team who had a lot of fun. They meshed very, very well together. And I think nobody was really surprised by Luke O'Brien. They were able to see him last year in floorball, but the addition of Corwin this year, it was a really great team between Woogas. And also, the goalie was very good as well. Lauren Russell, very proud of her. So what a tournament that we saw from Woogas, who really came in here and showed everybody what they can do. But We Got Ice, we know they have all the confidence in the world. How can you not when Jack Doyle is your goalie? But I think everybody was even more hyped that Dan had his moment. Dan has not gotten enough credit, and he hit that game-winning shot. So an incredible interview from both of them. A lot of respect to both those players. It's really hard after you lose a game to come in and talk like Wooga just did, so a lot of respect to them. But they also looked really good, because they're wearing their Shady Rays. You know all about our good friends at Shady Rays. If you lose them, if you break them, they're going to replace them. So don't you worry about that. Premium sunglasses for half the price that you could ever imagine spending anywhere else. And we've told you this before, but over a quarter of a million five-star reviews. Honest to God, I wear my Shady Rays a lot, and the Polaroid glasses are some of the best Polaroid glasses I've ever had. So make sure you guys go to ShadyRays.com, use the promo code FLOORBALL, and that'll get you $25 off each pair you buy. Okay, championship game is here. It is Team McFlurry Power. It is We Got Ice, and Paxton and I are going to lead you all the way with the pregame show. Here we go! It is the finals. All of the floorball games have led up to this, and you couldn't ask for much better of a matchup. You have Team McFlurry Power, who's been really the strong horse this entire tournament. Of course, the four Canadians, Tapwater Health Insurance, taking on Team We Got Ice, who has the most warehouse experience out of anybody in here, and you can't say enough about Reagan Rust. But Paxton, when you look at these two teams, evenly matched, what are you looking for today?
I mean, honestly, I think these are the two teams in this entire tournament that are going to give us the best final matchup. I think we got the defense. I think we got the skills in both Chelsea and in Reagan. And the conversations we had with them before this were really interesting, because We Got Ice was calm, cool, collected, and so was McFlurry Power. But Chelsea's confidence was a little shaken, which I was curious about. But the conversations were great.
How are you guys feeling going into this championship game against McFlurry Power, who have never been in the finals?
Good.
Mike.
Good.
That's it?
I think we're feeling good.
Yeah. After the first game, K-Mac and me shared a nice embrace. You know, we're good friends, and we both said to each other, we're going to play in the finals. So I think we both knew this was coming. I feel great. Sore, tired, but I want to win.
Yeah, we kind of felt, I think, like We Got Ice and us, that game one was going to be kind of the championship game. And kind of turned out that way, and both teams been able to kind of adjust and figure out how we're going to play together and do this and that, but not worried.
I specifically asked McFlurry Power after their semifinal game to go to the finals who they didn't want to play. And you guys were the answer, which is funny because now you're playing them.
Yeah. Nobody wants to play Reagan and Dan out there. They're dogs.
They basically said that you guys are just going to run them.
Oh, yeah.
And run them and run them. Is that your strategy? Do you have any other strategy going into this final against McFlurry Power? Because they do have Chelsea and Nick, which are two very good floorball players.
We all discussed that we are gazelles. At this point, we're just going to keep running and gunning.
We are gazelles.
When you guys look at Team We Got Ice, who you've gotten to see play a lot throughout this tournament, whether it was against you or not, like, what stands out to you about that team?
Speed. speed. We play very slow. We play very methodical, controlled approach.
Methodical.
And thank you. And Zoe buzzes around. DZ got his feet going, and Reagan.
The crazy motors. Crazy motors. Reagan throws the body around, yeah. So we got to be physical. And she likes to go, yeah, 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 in situations yes. where it's not necessary to throw you
yeah.
off.
Don't know what all game. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yep, yep, yeah, yeah, yep.
To look for that.
Yeah, yeah.
Listen, ears.
Okay, so good to hear from both yeah. teams. You know, both of them about to play in the biggest games of their lives. And we had to get Chelsea the confidence back because she has been so good this tournament. You hear what all the teammates had to say about her, and you heard it from them. They're going to be gazelles.
Yeah, they're going to be gazelles, not starfish, not farm animals, which is interesting because that's what they've been this entire tournament. But truthfully, Kels, I think this is going to be a low-scoring game. I think it's going to be defense-focused, and I think we're going to see a lot of running from yeah. them, for sure.
It's going to be very physical, and it's going to yeah. be very evenly matched. But the most even person, the greatest nice. Person in this warehouse is Jolly Olive, and here yeah. he is to bring you the stats that you need to know.
You're welcome.
The day is finally here. Thanks for kicking it over, guys. We're finally at the championship game, and who else but We Got Ice has clawed their way back after losing their first game to make it here in the final, but they have their toughest challenge yet because they're facing Team Canada, McFlurry Power. Let's start with the one seed. It all starts with the name on the face of the team, and that's Kyle MacDonald in the net. He leads all goalies with an 86% save rate and 38 saves on the tournament. Not only is the defense great on this team, but K-Mac in the goal is letting almost nothing through. Nick and Chelsea up front, they're the only two players out of everyone with six or more goals in the tournament, and they play for the same team. In fact, they've both taken exactly 35 shot attempts. It's basically having two of the same players on your offense that bodes well for the team in purple. Pavel, when playing for this great team, is 3-for-3 in his shots on goal and shot made. So when he comes on the floor for the purple team, he's almost always sinking his shots. Last but not least, McFlurry Power, they're shooting 36% from the field. That's 14% better than the second place team, which happens to be We Got Ice, who has improved a lot throughout the going of this tournament. How about DZ on the floor? Kind of started out as the GOAT of the first game. Now he leads We Got Ice with 4 goals made and a 27% shot rate, obviously courtesy of his 2-goal game that won them the semifinals. Over on the other corner, Reagan, though, kind of had a slower game. Didn't record a single shot on goal after leading the team in shots on goal heading into the semifinal. We'll see if that changes at all or if they stick with the game plan with DZ leading the offense. Jack Doyle, he needed to have a big game in net, and he absolutely did. He went 11-for-12 in the net, only allowing 1 goal, which was the key difference in the game that got We Got Ice a 2-1 overtime win. As for We Got Ice, a big-time legacy game. We obviously know that Team Jack won the Roulette League, where it was Jack and Zoe in Blitzball. We Got Ice, as a franchise, has never hoisted a banner. They got close in Blitzball Battle 3, their only championship appearance ever, where they lost to Como Blitzball in a close game. This will be their second attempt. As for McFlurry Power, they haven't even gotten close to a championship before. Their only other semifinal appearance before this was Blitzball Battle 1, where they lost to Baggage right before the final. This will be their first shot in a championship game. It's going to be an awesome game. I have no idea who's coming out on top, but let's kick it back to the booth to see what else we need to know.
Thanks, guys. I'm Ronnie here with Jeff. We are shooting the championship game right now. We're directing and switching. It's crazy out there. We are staying here ready to, and the crowd's going nuts. Vibes could not be higher. Can't wait to see who comes out on top. Back to you guys.
Ready
two
on
K-Mac. Ready two on K-Mac.
Take two. Ready one.
Ready one.
Take one.
Thank you very much, Pavel Barber. We have arrived safely here at the last game, Floorball 2023, the unbeaten number one seed, McFlurry Power, taking on We Got Ice, a pair of teams that are anxiously awaiting to see whether or not they can hang their first banner here in the warehouse. McFlurry Power, they are dominant. They lead the league in goals scored. In fact, Chelsea Dinnan and Nick Bowens both lead the league in scoring individually, 6 goals apiece. They are a well-oiled machine.
Absolutely, and we saw the last game that Baggage was doing a good job shutting down Kelsey, trying to not give her too much time and space. We'll see if We Got Ice got that scouting report there.
With We Got Ice, everybody loves them from the blitzball world, but they've got a prime opportunity to win Floorball Season 2. We know all about Jack and Zoe and Reagan Russ, the former Division I hockey captain at Boston University, but perhaps their secret weapon is the guy that now leads the team in scoring, DZ. He is the reason why they are here with the overtime game winner in the semis.
Yeah, we don't talk much about him, but we definitely should be. Maybe it's just people are so focused on the two studs up front they forget about him, but he's doing his job. He's creeping in there. He's getting it done.
All right, so give me a prediction.
I'm going to go with Mac Fleury. I've ridden this team the entire time with good odds. I've loved playing with them. I think I've scored pretty much every time
Every time you have, by the way.
Is that right?
That is right.
I will give them the edge, though I do not think it's going to be very easy for them. We Got Ice was looking phenomenal last game.
Yeah, you've scored 3 goals in 3 tries on the Pavel play with McFleury power, but you've had a tremendous success rate with We Got Ice as well. You've been called upon 4 times. You have a goal. You got 2 apples as well.
Yeah,
those this are guy assists for those of you that don't know the lingo.
This guy loves the terminology.
I love it.
They're the only team I've assisted, I think, in this entire tournament. So it is fun playing with them as well, getting the pressure off me. Just let them do their stuff.
So you've got McFleury power. I think it's time for We Got Ice. I know they've been grinders when it comes to blitzball. You looked at them during floorball. You said, yeah, semi-talented team. I think they're going to be kissing the trophy at the end of the day.
All right, we will see.
Hey, let's send it on over to Paxton and Kelsey and get their predictions.
Thank you, Rosie. Pax, I'm letting you go first, girl.
We Got Ice. I've been riding with them this entire tournament. Had them in BB3-2, and they fell so close, so short. But I got them winning this. I feel it in my heart. It's a little cold because it's icy. We Got Ice.
And they have the momentum from the last
game.
What a game we saw from them. I'm going to go ahead and take Team McFleury Power, the strongest team in this tournament, who has not wavered throughout. As you can hear, we're getting much closer to game time, guys. It should be a good one. Rosie, we'll get it back to you.
So interesting, a 2-2 split on the predictions. Boy, that's how close the season has been. We cannot wait to bring it to you later. Inside the warehouse, a trophy will be kissed. A banner will be raised. Will it be McFleury Power? Will it be We Got Ice? We'll find out when we see you here in Jersey City. We'll catch you then.